Thank you very much. It's a great honor for me that I can introduce Ms. Gabriel. And for me, it's very important because, as you will see later on, I believe her and Ms. Vestager are the two most important persons for the digital ecosystem. And I will allude why I do think that is. Starting, I would like to do with a little intro. I'm proud as a European proud. So, isn't that great? We can be so proud to be Europeans. We have such a lovely country, and I think it's worth fighting for. So, but what has happened the last years? Who of you can still name a global relevant auditing firm from Europe? Pity, pity, the US has conquered it all. Who of you can name some global relevant European law firms? So it's all been exported. And now we come to my favorite topic. Who of you can still see big European banks? So that was in 2011. And this is today. So, and I think that this is very much due to regulation, that the European sector was more exposed to than the US one. And that is why we need regulation to be very careful with the industry to come and which are still intact. So, but it could get worse, and it continually gets worse. So, and we all let that happen with us. So this is what happens when you call a friend who works at the UBS on his private mobile device.
UBS is required to record this call.
Did you hear this? Every time you call an employee of a bank now, or he calls you, before you have a single word, it is UBS is required to record that call. And when you ask the banker afterwards, who I'm sure is totally annoyed after he had explained that the first 100 times, he said, we have to do that because the US wants to know if and how we speak with our clients about US stocks, if we then afterwards place an order with a US stock. I think we have come a long way to bend over. And it's even getting worse what the banks need to do in order to comply with what the US likes to. I'll give you a story. I do my investments via a company in Switzerland. And in that this company in Switzerland had shares in a company, listed company in Sweden, where we pooled some interest and bought equity stakes in the three leading Iranian internet companies. So when suddenly I get a call from the Credit Suisse, and they said, we found out that you, Klaus, in your holding as a share of a company in Sweden that has an Iranian equity participation, and there's legally nothing wrong with it. But we are afraid of the Americans don't like it, so either you sell these shares or we close your accounts. So this is the degree of freedom the banks have because of more or less by the US forced regulation, and that's why we don't need to be surprised that the equity development looks like it looks. Let's come to the next sector. The next sector is, here you see, 15% of the market cap. The US has been, the Deutsche Bank has been fined for distributing, not originating, toxic instruments. next sector, I spoke to one of the owning family members. They paid $28 billion to the US. And I'm sure it's just coincidence that 1 week after they paid, the US eased the law and the threshold for diesel intoxication in the US. Yeah, so I think that must have been really a great moment for the Fauvé family. So the other situations what I see is also that we creating these kind of disparities, being too shy and not being decisive enough to support our own industry, we have created this digital deficit, which where we basically export 65%, we have a deficit of $68 billion. This is the future industry and it's getting worse and worse. So there's a lot to watch for the regulators as well. So what do we need to do? I have the luck that Ms. Gabriel now sees these kind of topics. There are a lot of topics which I think are interesting, a lot of topics which you can tackle, but there are only three very decisive ones that make a huge difference for our economy. So the first one is net neutrality and platform neutrality. So what do I mean with this? So we do respect free forces, yeah, of economy if everybody adheres to it. But the way these kind of players use their political power is too odd sometimes, to say the least. So we need to be in a position to first recognize what is happening there and then also trying to act decisively. The next thing is this net neutrality. So I do not think that it is acceptable that some players with very huge financial means can have a faster way on the Autobahn than little startups, because you just open up another field where the US potent big companies can discriminate our smaller companies. So the next is enforceability of legal action. This is a very nice topic. So the US fined Fauvé with 27% of their market cap. The US fined Deutsche Bank for redistributing the CDOs with 15% of the market cap. BNP was fined with 7.4 billion at a 50 billion market cap. And then, I don't sure if you can read this minuscule number on the right-hand side. Yeah, so the EU fined Google with 30 days of profit and 0.4% of the market cap. So I think having these kind of magnitudes, we miss the purpose of it. Because if these punishments are so small, they become part of a business plan and you can easily accept them and still keep doing what you do. So I think that this has to be rethought and we need to be more courageous given the examples that the US anyway showed us. The other thing, thank you. The other things, what I have had, some examples which I saw on privacy. I was sitting with English-speaking person in Las Vegas. He had a startup in Germany, but his phone was in English. And we talked about the situation that Deutsche Telekom is distributing the Alexa. And I discussed that a little bit with him. And then 10 minutes later, he called me and said, you don't see what's happening. I got an advertisement of Facebook for the Alexa in German. So if you look at it, my assumption or my only conclusion, either it's serendipity or Siri listened into our discussion and then served the ad. So these are situations we need to carefully watch from the regulatory side and dig into it. And if that happens, we need to have a different instruments to faster react on it. If we take the current path, it takes too long, and then it doesn't achieve the purpose we want. Another example, which I think why regulation and active regulation is important, I thought a little bit about this topic, cryptocurrencies and blockchain. And I was on a conference where a Chinese person told me something where I finally understood what is the importance. So currently we do have coins. We do have Geldscheine and we have a way to store our wealth that is ours and that we can use to consume. But what is in 15 years when there is no cash anymore and we only have our wealth, our money in accounts, and suddenly our banks suddenly get pressured in a way that they get pressured today and freeze your account. You are not even able to move anything. You are totally dependent on that. So, and I would, for me, very much hope that we till then have a regulated cryptocurrency that we control, where we define our own destiny, and it cannot be that our money needs to stay our money and cannot be blocked by somebody who's not even in our legislation. So, summing up, the third one, which is very important, is we need to have more capital in the system, because these are the most successful European companies. And as you can see, the last two financing rounds have been done with non-European governed money. So there's nothing to say about it, except that they define this SPAs. They sit in the supervisory board, and this way we export the governance of our most successful companies to another legislation. I feel discontent that we are not able in Europe to be also governing these kind of companies, because they are the hope for future employment, for future innovation, for anything. We need to control our destiny there. So, all in all, I would like to stress that these are the three facts: net and platform neutrality, enforceability of legal actions, and creation and deployment of large pockets of money. So unfortunately, these are way more uncomfortable to manage, and it is way more difficult to get into the box ring with the big ones from the US and try to push this through than saying I want broadband penetration, because the worst that can happen is that it comes 5 years later. But I think we are here to help, to offer the help, to calibrate all these kind of necessities that need to be done by the EU. But this is the one where the fight will be won, and all the others is just a side effect. So I would be very happy if this could have, to some extent, given you a little guidance on what we think is important, and if that finds some way the way into your priority list. And please always come to us as a whole of industry. We rely on you, as you probably also rely on us. Thank you very much, and good luck.